Hello and welcome to the 2013 Level 5 Catfish's Ma! My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already, and I will be your host on today's... Never mind. My name is Josh Jepson. Welcome back. Playing Link's Awakening. And we are starting today Catfish's Ma, Level 5. I'm going to try to breeze through this dungeon. I'm going to be completely honest with you. I did practice this dungeon beforehand, because... this is the dungeon that always gives me trouble. That and the last dungeon of the game. They give me trouble. Can you turn around, sir? Thank you. This dungeon always gives me trouble, and I'm not sure why. I mean, it's kind of a little bit complicated, more so than the previous dungeons in the game, but it's not overly complicated. It's pretty straightforward when you think about it. You just gotta go in all the right rooms. But that's kind of the case anyway. It's a lot less linear than the other ones, and I think I was mentioning that in the previous dungeon, how that dungeon was a little less linear, and they all get a little bit less linear as time goes on. But this is the least linear one so far, because there's a lot of different options to go. There's actually even the mid-boss is actually completely optional. Well, sort of. There's two mid-bosses, and we'll get to that when we get to that, but... right now, we just need to get some keys, yo. Some keys. And I'm not talking about the bats. I'm not talking about the bats, neither. I'm talking about the fact that I can't speak, even. Oh my goodness. Block puzzles. I always push those blocks down for some reason. I find myself doing that every single time I play this dungeon. I don't know why. What's in this room? Nothing. I guess we'll come back to that later. Or maybe not. I don't know. Actually, I do know. I can't really bluff since I can't really feign ignorance here because I just told you that I practiced this dungeon. I know exactly what's going to happen. And I know exactly how annoying these assholes are. Helmasaurs. Actually, they're called Iron Masks in this game. I believe I talked about this in the previous. Maybe not. I don't know. This might even be the first time we've seen them in this game. I honestly can't remember. It's been an awful long time since I played this game, like, regularly, so... at least it's felt like a long time. The last couple weeks, I've been sort of on a pseudo-vacation. I'd say it's a vacation, but at the same time, I was also doing things that will further my career. But, anyway. Regardless of that, it was a fun trip, but I'm glad to be back to playing some Zelda for you guys. Which, by the way, Zelda games on my channel, I've done an awful lot of them already, but, there's actually a couple, I've been really feeling Zelda lately, I've been feeling like playing a lot of Zelda lately, hence this LP, obviously, but, there's other games, other Zelda games that I would like to do, and I'm pretty sure I've mentioned this before. Can I jump over? Thank you. But I do plan on doing pretty much every Zelda game in existence on this channel at some point. Because I get asked about that a lot. I'm like, people ask me if I want to do a Skyward Sword LP. Or, well, it's mostly Skyward Sword that people ask me to do. But I do plan to do most of the Zelda games, if not all of them. Eventually, over time. That's actually kind of the founding thing for my channel. Is the fact that I will be doing pretty much every Zelda game. Like, I started off doing Twilight Princess on this channel, and now here we are at Link's Awakening, and I've done... well, I don't know, I haven't done that many Zelda games, really, if you think about it. There's still a lot that I have yet to do. Including Majora's Mask. Majora's Fuck. Which I don't really want to do, to be completely honest with you. But I'll get into that at a later time. If you can't kill Kilgan with a sword, try using a bomb! Alright, well, I'll think about that. What's going on? Hello? Oh no! It's a big skeleton. This guy is so easy. He's like the guys from... Arg, I can't beat you. Oh, actually, my beams do damage to him? That's weird. So the beams from my level 2 sword do damage to him? That's cool, because normally you're supposed to slash him and then place a bomb on him, like the Stalfosses in an Ocarina of Time. But I guess the beam does damage. I didn't even know that. I just discovered this right now. It's incredible. Give me your... oh. What? I've got what's inside this box. Come and get it if you can. Love, Master Skull. Master Stalfos. What's down here? I actually know what's down here, but I'm going to go down here anyway just to look, because we won't be coming back to this area later. I mean, we can come back later, but I just want to get what's down here. Because this is a completely optional path here. Hello, Stalfosses. You are not my enemies. You are my friends. I want to be friends with all of these guys. Oh, it's a good thing I came down here. Well, not really. I mean, I got a piece of power out of it. So that's kind of cool. But no, I wanted the owl statue here is the one I want to talk to. Hey, guy.
Dive under where the torchlight beams do cross.
Keep that in mind, folks. Keep that in mind. And we will, oh my god, I'm flying. Look how fast I'm going. Oh my god, it's like hyperspeed. The, piece of power. Giving me strong-ass legs, yo. Alright, anyway. So this is actually an interesting thing, and they use this in other Zelda games too, namely the Oracle ones. I've seen this used, where you have to go up and then back down to like, make your way across the rooms. Actually, I think, oops, I need to push the button. It's okay, because I have defense! There we go. Actually, I believe that, A Link to the Past did that at some point, the whole thing where you have to, you're in a room, yeah.
Gulp, you found me. You're a real pesky kid, you know that?
This guy has a different voice every time I talk to him. There we go. I don't have beams anymore, so I have to take him out the old traditional way. The old-fashioned way, with sword and bomb. Oh, snap. Oh, okay, I thought he had more health than that. I can't beat you, I'm out of here. So as you can see, this boss, this mid-boss, is really, really unique in that he leaves. He goes away. Where am I actually going? Oh, snap! Here, stop it. I actually went the wrong way. I was supposed to go... Actually, I don't remember where I'm supposed to go. Oh, no! Oh, no! I think I have to go up, actually. I think I have to go up. The reason this confuses me, because every time I go up here, I see stuff like that treasure chest that I can't get, and whatnot. This confuses me, but we do need the map at some point, so let's go get the map. I think that's up this way somewhere. And there's more bombs somewhere around here if you absolutely, absolutely need to go out of your way to get them. Because you didn't do very well playing the game and you didn't get the upgrade that gives you 1.5 million bombs that you'll never run out of. Alright. That puzzle right there always got to me. The one where you have to actually push the block to get the enemy on the other side. It's kind of not a super obvious one. I like that. I like that. I like this dungeon. But at the same time, I hate it. I don't want to say I like it, because I've noticed that about myself in past LPs and such. Saying, oh, I love this dungeon. And then at the end of the dungeon, I'm like, wow, I hate this dungeon. Or at some point, I'm like, I hate this part of the dungeon. I hate this part of the dungeon. But I love this dungeon. And it makes no sense. So I just need to make up my goddamn mind. So, oh, I didn't get to look at it, but in each of the rooms that we've been fighting him in, if you haven't noticed, there are three blocks at the corners. Well, in that room there was. The first time we fought him, there was only one block at the corner. The second time we fought him, there was two blocks. Have we seen a room? Have we seen a room that has four blocks yet? No? Well, you're stupid, because we have. And the map will show us the way. Well, I mean, not really. It's the one way, way down there. And you know what? There's a super, super easy way to get there. Because it's near the beginning of the dungeon, if I haven't mentioned this already, and I don't think I did in the LP, but Mambo's Mambo that we got from that sunfish guy not only transports you to Mambo's pond near the village, but it also transports you to the beginning of the dungeon. Hell yeah! They have to have something like that, because it's like the magic mirror in Link to the Past, and other Zelda games have a similar kind of thing. I believe there's a way to do it. Faror's Wind in Ocarina of Time has that. This dungeon has an awful lot of backtracking, too, I've noticed. Alright. No, get out of my fife. My fife. I was gonna say, get out of my face and life in the same sentence. Really? I wish there was an easier way to kill these camasaurs. Please, for the love of God, turn your buttocks towards me so I can slap. No! See, you cheated! You're turning around right when I'm hitting you. This is not fair. Die. Die. This, you turn, give me your butt. Thank you. All right. Now let's make our way back this way. Oh God, I don't need to fight you right now. See, this is why I get defense, because there are a lot of rooms in the game that I like to just tank through. And it's nice to not die while you're trying to do that. You know what I'm saying? Because a lot of people were upset when I got the blue tunic instead of the red tunic. They're like, you could double your power by 3! Because that's double! And that's just what you guys sound like. Exactly like that. Out of my face. Alright, Skeletor. This is your final stand. Give me my item, or I will behead you. You again? You keep going and going, I can't outlast you.
That's what she said.
Hell yeah. Bomb your face. I like that these guys remind me a lot of the Stalfosses from Ocarina of Time. Which is good, because those guys are really cool. Wait, is it Ocarina of Time that I'm thinking of? What game had really cool Stalfosses? I know Twilight Princess had a lot of really cool looking enemies. And with that, he drops the pump from Dig Dug. No, you've got the hook shot. Its chain stretches long when you use it. That's what she said. Okay. Anyway, continuing on, let's go backtrack again. Do we need to? Yeah, I'll just backtrack. I was gonna say I'll use Mambo's Mambo, but nah. But nah, I'll just play the game. Because I do believe there's actually another way that we need to go when we go back here somewhere. The map doesn't make sense, though. Because we go down underground here, and suddenly we end up at the very top of the map over there. That's weird. I don't know. Just because they ran out of space or something. I don't know. Oh, you know what? I just got the hook shot. Let's try and use that, shall we? Die! Yeah, you don't deserve to live in this world anymore. This is my personal opinion of you, and it's not a very good one, so you probably ought to get yourself checked out. Because my opinion is the most important opinion of all time. Anyway, now that we have the hookshot, we actually get a ton of extra rupees in this dungeon. 200 rupees?! Damn right I'm ecstatic! Can you hear it in my voice, how ecstatic I am? The hookshot is pretty much the ultimate weapon. Because it's just as strong as the sword, as your level 2 sword, I believe. And it kills the Helmosaurs. You know, without worrying about their helmets. And it extends, obviously, its reach. I almost forgot what I was talking about there. Like, I got distracted. I'm like, wait a minute, where the hell am I going now? I have no idea. So anyway, let's go this way. Up! Yep, you can't get past that without getting the hookshot. And even if you could, even if you did manage to jump over each of these gaps and avoid getting hit by those, yeah, they kind of have a safeguard here where you can't go anywhere and do anything because you suck. Let me get these, what are they? You know, the arrows floating in midair here? The Pharaohs! The Pharaohs! Cause get it? Cause it looks like a fairy? No? Okay. Love you. Alright. Anyway, small key. So now here's where things get interesting. There's one of two things that we can do. We can actually go right now and get the boss key and go to the boss. We can do that right now. Or we can use our key that we just got and fight an optional side boss, an optional mini boss, which is actually technically the actual mini boss of this dungeon. This is the one that actually gives you the warp back to the beginning. And he is over here. Ah, it's two mini bosses, like usual, actually. The key cavern, I believe, had two mini bosses of the same kind. Where's my arrows? Now, see, the reason this is optional is because the bow is optional. I feel like it wouldn't have been otherwise. Oh, there you go. So it takes 3 arrows, and if you manage to get it in early enough, you can get all 3 arrows in before he closes his eye. Now, the only thing that, the only problem with this boss is that you have to kind of coax Goma. It's Goma, by the way. Goma into opening their eye. There we go. No, I only got 2 in. That's all right. One more, fool. Open your eye again. Don't make me wait. Because usually that's the problem with this boss, is that it makes you wait forever. It just goes back and forth and back and forth. Sometimes it attacks you, and sometimes it opens its eye, and it's like it's completely random. And that's not, I don't approve of that. Goma, No, don't attack me. Nobody likes that. Because you don't actually hit me. It's kind of a sucky attack. No, okay. You're so slow. Why did you growl at me? Okay, why did you growl at me? Open your eye, goddammit! Stop attacking me! I don't actually know if there's a way to coax Goma into opening his eye. Or not. Please? No? Any day now. Really? There we go. Done. Alright, fine. Did you actually give me a fairy? Because that would be nice. No, just a heart, but that's fine. Anyway, we gotta warp back to the beginning. And we open this door over here. We'll actually get back to that later. That's gonna take us to a completely dead end, because it's gonna take us right to where the boss door is, but it's unfortunately blocked by another small key. And we don't have any more small keys left, so... So actually, we need to go right now and find our way. We're gonna get the boss key and another small key, obviously, and then we can just make it to the end of the dungeon. I'm actually surprised at how straightforward I made this dungeon team. It's really not that bad if you know what you're doing. It really isn't. And this makes up for the short episode from previous. So anyway, if you come up here, we didn't really explore any of these rooms up here. Let's go this way first. Oh god. You know what? I can tank hits. That's why I am surviving. So if you remember correctly, we found a stone owl that told us about diving where the torches cross. That would be this obvious diving hole. So let's explore this place. Goomba, you know what? I see you up there being a bitch, and I'm gonna stomp your face. So I can have full hearts and shoot laser beams from my freaking forehead. Alright, can I... The only disadvantage to doing that is that I have to go into my inventory and waste time getting my feather back out. Alright. Ooh, look at this. There must be a key here, for I hear my compass making noise. I'd be quite concerned if my compass started beeping at me. Pretty sure they're not supposed to do that. Anyway, you've got the Nightmares key. We still need to get a small key, though, but if you remember correctly, there's a bunch of chests over there that we couldn't get before, because we didn't have the hookshot, but now that we have the hookshot, we can get them. And some of them are going to be rupees, so I'm excited about that, because we spent all of our hard-earned rupees on that goddamn bow, and I'm like stingy with money now. Because I had zero rupees, mind you. I was broke, man. I was broke. And it didn't feel good, man. Didn't feel good. Okay. Anyway, we get to backtrack here, and this is the most annoying room, because this happens! Here you are trying to fight these guys, and tank hits, and all this junk. Ugh. Just want to make through without getting hit by anything. I'm gonna get hit by this bubble, because fuck him! Oh, for some reason I can't hit these guys in midair. That's weird. Because you can hit, like, other bosses and stuff in midair. Maybe they're just bigger, that's why. Alright, so up here, now that we have the hookshot, 50 rupees! Very nice! And over here, small key. And like I said before, there's gonna be a small key door, like a small key block, blocking the way to get to the boss. So if you didn't want to do the optional Goma battle, it's actually a lot faster. Like, the dungeon goes by a lot faster. So if you're speedrunning the game, it might be a good idea to skip the optional boss. But at the same time, now that I've done that, it's actually gonna be a lot easier, it's a lot faster for me to get to where the boss door is, because if I use Mambo's Mambo and go back to the beginning of the dungeon, there's gonna be a warp waiting for us that's actually gonna take us right to where Goma was. And if you remember, I did say that that leads to the boss door eventually, so I don't know. Speedrunners, you got your work cut out for you figuring out which is faster. I do not want to dedicate the time to doing such things. The other way to get there, that I won't be going to, excuse me, I showed it off earlier, but where the stone owl was that told us about diving, it was right after the first time we fought the skull guy, and we went down a flight of stairs. That's the other way to get to where the boss door is. I don't know if that's actually the correct way, though. I think you have to go this way at some point. Well, no, because it's an optional boss. See, because right here, Oh, right, right. I believe if you push this block here, that lets you get into here. And that over that side to the left there is where... well, I believe I showed it off anyway, so you know what I'm talking about. And up here... the boss. And I hate this guy. So let's see how well I do. Sometimes I do really good at this.
Kee-hee-hee! I shall eat you!
God, I'm scared now. Ah, it's a giant mace tail and a piranha sticking his face out of the wall. Apparently this is a snake. It doesn't look much like a snake to me, personally. Oh god. Now this guy, it's completely random which hole he pops out of. And so, more often than not, I find he appears when his freaking tail is right in the way. So I'm like trying to get out of the way of his tail, and then he appears and I don't have enough time to shoot at him. Right there would have been perfect if I didn't fall off the edge, but I did. Usually I like to stay to one side and try and... oh god, why did the tail, like, lag? This is not cool. This is the dumbest... I hate this boss. If I haven't expressed my discomfort with fighting this boss yet. Oh my god, stop appearing in the same hole! Three times in a... see, right there! See, he appears right when the tail is gonna be in front of his face. It's almost like it's impossible. There we go. That's better. I like to try to get... nope. Not gonna be able to do it fast enough. There we go! Oh, so good, so good, so good. So far, so good. Yes! Yeah!
Tisk, Tisk, you don't seem to know what kind of island this is. Kee-hee-hee-hee! What a fool. Kee-hee!
What is he talking about? I don't know what kind of island this is. It's just a normal island, right? An island surrounded by water, and I need to escape it. That's the whole idea. You've got the wind marimba!
Play that funky music, white boy. Shrine. An island secret in the shrine.
And with that, I'm going to call it an episode. I'm glad that I got this all done in one episode. Thank you guys for watching. I've been Josh Jepson, and I will see you in the next one. Really? I wish there was an easier way to kill these hamasaurs. Please, for the love of God, turn your buttocks towards me so I can slap- no! See, you cheated! You're turning around right when I'm hitting you. This is not fair. Die. Die. Just, you turn- give me your butt. Thank you.